All right, in this video, we're going to go ahead and show you how to create a vendor credit and then apply it to one of your bills. So this is that you are getting a return. So you're returning something to your vendor. You're sending it back because it was damaged, let's just say. And the vendor is issuing you a credit for that purchase. So you can either leave the credit on hand and apply it to a future purchase that you buy from them, or you can apply it to a bill that's currently outstanding. All right, and we're going to do the latter here. So first things first, one thing to be sure of, unlike in the client area where you have refunds and credits, for the enter bills, for the credits on vendors, you actually go into the enter bills area. Okay, up top here you see bill and you see credit, so we're going to choose a credit for now. Okay, and you pick your vendor, All Star Truck Sales. If it has a credit memo number on there, you can put it on there. What's the amount? $500. Why are they giving you a credit? So similar to on the bill, if you want to go look at this bill, you want to make sure that those are hitting the same account. So if it's $500 back for, let's say, repairs and maintenance on a car that they didn't end up needing to charge us, then you could put that there. But if it's for items that you're returning, you want to make sure that you put the proper items on here. Okay, and the reason for that is, especially if you're doing inventory items, if you are returning the inventory items to the vendor, you want to make sure that those quantities go down. All right, for now, we're just going to go ahead and stick with expenses here. We'll fill in our class, okay, and if you want any memo. Okay, any memo you want to put in there, you can do that. And we go ahead and say save and close. Okay, now once that is saved, you want to go up to your pay bills. And we're going to go ahead and show all bills. We're going to filter by the vendor, All Star Trucks. So when I click on this bill here, notice how it has the 1407. This bill is outstanding. And you can see down here that I have some credits available. Now, if I were to choose all vendors again, and I highlight Western Telephone Company, no credits available. So it does it based on what you're highlighting. Okay, so this is highlighted now. Now, if I want to apply it to this bill, I need to check off the box. All right, set credits. I want to check off the credit that I'm going to set and apply it. Now, if I didn't want to apply the whole thing, I could come in here and say $450 of it goes to this bill. And, you know, $50 would just sit there as a credit available. But for now, we're just going to say the whole $500. Say done. Notice that over here, it says credits used. Can't change that right here. I have to go into the set credits area if I want to change it more. And then it tells me that I have an amount to pay of $907, but I'm not going to be paying that right now. So I'm just going to actually zero that out. All right. And I'm going to go ahead and pay my selected bill. We'll zero it out in tab so it comes to zero. I'm going to go ahead and pay this bill. So what this is actually only going to do is it's just going to apply that credit to that bill. Okay. Doesn't give me an option to print checks because there's no check to print, obviously. But I can go in and pay more bills if I want to, or I can just go ahead and say I'm all done. So that's how you create a vendor credit and apply it to an open bill.